Hello guys, welcome to this Java tutorial for beginners. In our today's video, we will talk about String Builder and String Buffer classes in Java. So without wasting time, let's get started. Now let us look at the difference between our String and String Builder or String Buffer classes. So your first difference is that your String is a immutable class, whereas your String Builder and String Buffer are mutable classes. And your second difference is that your String Buffer class is thread safe, right? And you no need to worry about this thread safety right now. We will discuss this in one of our later video. All right. Now let us look at the difference between String and String Builder classes with help of this program. In this program, I have created two new objects. So one is of our String class and another one using the String Builder classes, right? And on our line 7, I have concatenated this string hello to the string object, right? And similarly on line 13, we use this append method to concatenate the hello string to the string builder object, right? So now let me run this program and, you know, let us see the output. Now let us compile the program and let us execute it. So here you can see we have the outputs as Gaurav, then another Gaurav, below that we have Ram, and after that we have Ram and hello. So let us see why this happened. Now if you look at the output, you know, you can see that our string Gaurav was printed twice, although we performed this concatenation operation on the string object, but this was not the case with the string builder object. So once we perform the append operation on the string builder object, the original object was modified. So this is the difference between the string and the string builder object. So basically, whenever you create an object in a string, that is immutable, which means that, you know, once you create it, you cannot modify it, right? So here on line 8, our string is still referring to the old object, that is Gaurav, right? And this is not the case with the string builder object. So here, if you want to print the new updated string, what you need to do is you need to write something like this string, and then, you know, need to refer to the new object. So now if I copy this and paste it over here, right, and let me print this again. So let me copy this, and now if I save this and run this, the output should be Gaurav hello. So let me show you this. Now let me compile and execute the program once again. So let me run it. And now you can see we have the output as Gaurav hello. All right. Now let us look at the four ways to create our string builder object. So first one is with the help of the string argument. So basically we can pass the string argument to the string builder constructor. Next, on line 9, we can see that we did not pass any argument to the string builder constructor. So basically what it does is it will create the string builder object with the initial capacity of 16. Similarly, on line 12, we have created the string builder object with the initial capacity of 10. So this 10 is nothing but the initial capacity. And don't worry about this right now. We will discuss this in the later part of the video. And finally, we have created the string builder object with the help of char sequence object. So char sequence is nothing but an interface that is implemented by the classes such as string, string build, string builder and string buffer. All right. Now let us understand capacity and why it is used in string builder. So the purpose of capacity is to specify the number of characters a particular string object will hold. So, you know, if you know before in hand how many characters the string buffer object will hold, then you can use it, as it will increase the performance, because every time you modify the content, you know, that is more than the capacity, then the content needs to be copied from the original storage to the larger storage, right, which might decrease the performance. All right. And here on line 5, I have specified the capacity as 10, right? Similarly, on line 9, I have not specified any capacity, so by default the capacity will be 16. And similarly on line 13, the capacity will be 20, because the initial, it will be 19, because the total capacity is 3 plus 16, because this length of the string is 3, and the original capacity what we get is 16. So now the capacity will be 19. So now let us run the program and verify the outputs. Now let me compile and execute the program. So let me run it. And here you can see we have the outputs as 10, 16 and 19. All right. Now let us look at some of the most important string builder methods. So first we have the capacity method. So as you have already seen that, you know, for a string builder object which is initialized with a string, so the capacity will be 16 plus the length of string, and in this case it will be 19. Next we have the length method. So length method will display the length of the string builder object. So here in this case the length of the string is 3, so it will display 3. Then we have the append method. So I've already shown you that append will concatenate the string after the string builder object. Then we have the delete method. So delete method will delete the characters from the start index and the end index minus 1, right? And similarly, we have this insert method. So insert method will contain two arguments. First, the position where you want to insert the dedicated string. And next, we have the string which we want to insert. And finally, we have the reverse method, so which will reverse the string builder object. So let me run the program and we can see the outputs. Now let me compile and execute the program. So let me run it. And here you can see we have the proper outputs. So that is it for the today's video. And don't forget to subscribe for more Java programming videos like this. And I will see you until next time.